how to configure my Spring Cloud Gateway application to request protected resources with the OAuth2 protocol. I've already made a video about creating a complete authorization server with OAuth2 and OpenID. Today, I will leave the same structure but only change the client as a Spring Cloud Gateway application. In the OAuth2 authentication protocol, there are three main components: the client server, the authorization server, and the resource server. The authorization server is the one which checks the credentials. The resource server is the one which contains data. The authorization server knows the resource server and it gives its protection. Everybody who wants to access the data of the resource server must be authorized by the authorization server. Finally comes the client. This one must be registered and accepted on the authorization server. This will create trust between the authentication server and the client server. The authorization server and the resource server are generally big applications consumed by multiple clients. I would rather work on the client application than develop an authorization server. If I'm building a simple application, a simple monolith application, I can use the OAuth2 client dependency with little configuration. I've done another video about that, you can check it. But if I'm working on a big application, on a microservice architecture, I would definitely have an API gateway in front of my application. The API gateway allows me to redirect the incoming requests to the internal microservices, having no logic in the API gateway, only redirection rules. This way, each microservice will have its own logic, and there is no necessity to have a master microservice which knows about the other microservices. But the API gateway is the only entry point to my microservice architecture. This means that it's the main responsible for the security. As my application is built on top of the Spring Cloud and Spring Boot dependencies, and I don't own the authorization server, neither the resource server, I must adapt my existing application to consume those servers. I'm already aware that when calling the authorization server, a login page will be returned. This is fine when everything is done from a browser. But what about using it from a backend API or from a mobile app? I just need the frontend to read the adequate headers, as location, redirect, to correctly display the login page. It can be widescreen or in an iframe. I've first registered a new client in the authorization server, with a client ID and a client secret. Those are the endpoints used to redirect after the successful logging. And those are the authorized scopes. To allow me performing tests on my local, I've created an alias for each server in the etc hosts. Otherwise, all the cookies will be written for the same server. So let's create my Spring Cloud Gateway application with Spring Initializer. And now the dependencies. The gateway dependency and the OAuth2 client dependency. Let's get this project and open it with IntelliJ. The main class doesn't need anything. With the gateway application, all will be done in the configuration file. Let's create it. I will start by setting the port and the name of the application. Now I want that my gateway fetches some information from the resource server. Every time the client server receives a request on the messages endpoint, the gateway will call the resource server at the messages endpoint. Nothing more, this is just a plain redirection. I can try it right now, but this won't work. Why? Because the resource server is protected with the OAuth2 security protocol. So I must configure my gateway as an OAuth2 client now. Here are the client ID and the client secret stored in the authorization server. Here are the scopes the gateway will request against the authorization server. This is the OAuth2 grant type I will use. The redirection URL after the authentication is successful. This is a standard URL in the OAuth2 protocol. And finally, where to locate the authorization server. Okay, now I have the authorization server which has the client registered. On the other side, my gateway is configured to authenticate against the authorization server and route the request to the resource server. Nevertheless, the resource server must know that any incoming request is validated by the authorization server. For that, I have to use the following filter. What is this for? Spring Gateway will forward any incoming security token from the request to the destination. Once the client is authenticated through the authorization server, it will use a security token in its request. This token will be now forwarded to the resource server, and this token will be used by the resource server to trust the request. Let's make a quick test. I will test my client gateway with curve. This is to simulate the usage from a frontend, from a mobile application, as an API. I can see here the redirection code and where the request will be redirected. If the requests are made from a browser, the redirection will be done automatically. The browser will load automatically this new URL, and this URL will display the login page of the authorization server. Nevertheless, if the requests are made from a backend consuming the API, the redirection must be handled by my application. The frontend or the mobile app must notice that's a redirection with the HTTP code 301. Then display the login page within an iframe or something else. When the user signed in correctly, I must handle the final result, which is the response from the resource server. Okay, let's make a quick recap. I was using an existing authorization server and resource server which don't belong to me. I registered my client into the authorization server to obtain the client ID and client secret. I create my client with the dependencies Spring Gateway and OAuth2 client. I configure the routing to request the resource server. I configure the OAuth2 protocol with the URL of the authorization server, the client ID and the client secret. And finally add the token relay filter which will forward the security tokens from the client server to the resource server. That's all for this video. As always, click on the thumbs up, leave a comment and see you in another video. Bye!